Hey guys, it's Jeremy here with Fruited Productions, and on today I'm going to show you how to ghost purge in Halo 3. There's little things we have to do before we can actually start. So, when you're in the lobby, for easiest terms, if you're wanting to do this by yourself, just change it to the network from Xbox Live or whatever to local, and then press X, or my bad, press the start button, go over to settings, game controls, go down to button layout, change that from default or whatever you have your settings set to bumper jumper. Press A, press B twice to get out of there. All I'm doing this on is a blank Foundry canvas map, but you can do it on any map you want. It doesn't matter. So whatever map you want, I'm just using a Foundry blank because there's nothing in the way to get in the way. So first of all, you're going to start off, right? Just fly around until you get open to an open spot around here. And you know what? Say I want to block off this hole, all the way right flush to here. Right to there. What we'll do is we will grab two double boxes. We'll set one double box right there. We'll set the other double box right here. We'll take the man cannon, move it right against one, and we'll put a man cannon against the other. This is to test and see if we made it, so this is why you need bumper jumper. Make one to the respawn time or whatever to never. So you'll go up to one. After your arrow says green or whatnot, press X. Change respawn time from 30, which is the default on double boxes, to never. Just for one of them. Leave the other one with all the settings the same. Alright? Go on top of one, just like so. Then turn back in the forge mode. And at the same time, you gotta do this very quickly. Press up on the directional pad and A. And if you did it right, it should go flying like crazy like that. Do it for both of them. See it? There we go. Now what you want to do is find the one that is 30. So that's the one that's 30, that's the one that's never. Pick up the 31, alright, press X as you are going to the settings. Now press X again, it'll bring up a new budget summary. Change the runtime maximum to 2. And just sit tight for a little bit, it should take 15 to 20 seconds. Alright, now that you can see that it'll automatically just do its thing if you do that. Now you can see that there's two boxes. One, though, can go through it, like anything. And you can move it around wherever you want. Even if you just wanted to put it there, which is kind of a waste of two boxes, considering you could do, you could just do the regular floating glitch kind of thing. But this is great for this kind of thing, because it's kind of hard, and plus you get a precise set because it doesn't jump around. So all you want to do is get it in place from where you want it. It's kind of sensitive, so be careful. Get it nice and angle. Move it up. Move it towards you guys. Oops, I had it perfect. Oh, there. Now just press A. And it's now been successfully molded. You can see that? All corners are clear, molded as can be. So, and that's how you do ghost merging. It was found actually not too long ago, in September of 09, apparently is what I heard. And it's a neat thing. The only bad thing that I wish maybe that it wouldn't have to do is, you can see that there's only one, right? There's not another one anywhere on the map that you can get or move. But if I press X, go up to double boxes, you can see that there's two placed on the map. It's still sweet that you could do this, but I just wish it would only take one, and then you could forge maximum amount, because now you can only mold half of the boxes. Well, you can only mold half of the boxes, then there's no more double boxes to use, but then you could switch on to double boxes, opes, and single boxes, etc. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Sorry guys, or fans of Fruit Dude, I haven't been doing videos lately. I've been busy with school and stuff like that, but I plan to do tons of gaming videos and programming videos using not AppleScript anymore, because AppleScript is kind of, I covered all the basics for people. If anybody wants advanced ones, they can request a tutorial, etc. Advanced AppleScript. But I'm going to make ones on Visual Basic using just the basic, the Microsoft Basic coding and stuff like that. We'll make Jeopardy, and we'll make some Yahtzees and Calculator and Math Tutor, etc., etc. So just stay tuned for those videos. See you guys later.